I'm Brian Winnikins. We are at World Dairy Expo. Thank you to our World Dairy Expo sponsors, and they include AMPI, along with the Farm First Dairy Cooperative, along with the Darrellin Equipment Services, the Plainview, Minnesota, and Woodville, Wisconsin. DeKalb Asgrow Seeds, Samantha Brantner, she's your representative serving Northwest Wisconsin. Compeer Financial and BASF, Ashley Gausman, serving Northwest Wisconsin. I am with Steve Maddox. We're at the DMI booth, and Steve's one of the DMI board members. He's from California, and we're going to be talking about the Undeniably Dairy program that's something brand new from DMI. I know that, Steve, that came out really right around June. I remember that at May or June, I remember it at the Dunn County Dairy Breakfast. Why the change?
Well, Brian, basically it came out for June Dairy Month. That's when we brought it out. But it's a new effort, but it's an unprecedented effort of trying to inform the consumers of what we do on the farm, how much we care, from grass to the glass, of a total sustainability effort on taking this nutritious product right to the consumer. Most consumers are third, fourth generation away from the farm. They have no concept of it. And we've got to fight out some of the misinformation out there and let them know really what actually is happening to take care of these beautiful animals.
So how does the Undeniably Dairy program then work to get that information out to consumers?
Basically putting out, highlighting how we take care of the cattle, how we feed the cattle, all the testing, all the science going into these animals that we are passionate about, and providing this nutritious product for them.
And so consumers are able to access social, is there a social media component, a website component?
We have all the above. We have a website component, we have social media replies, they can talk directly to dairymen if they wish. We have referrals to different sites, trying to give them the real information, the unvarnished truth, without throwing any bias into it.
And so when consumers, when they go to the website, are they able to even ask questions or leave comments?
They can leave comments, they can also leave questions, and they'll be replied back to normally by dairymen themselves, the staff. We will put them in direct contact many times just to hear from the horse's mouth, so to speak.
Talking with Steve Maddox, he is one of the board members for DMI, and he's from California. Now, one of the things that you even came up with a new logo, and that's even being used on Domino's pizza boxes and a lot of other items as well. And take a look at the logo. Why this type of a logo?
It's easy to identify. It's sharp, and the heart in the middle of the cow shows our passion for what we do, and that's what it's really all about.
Did any of the Jersey or Guernsey guys say, hey, there's a Holstein here?
They complained a lot, but you know what? This is the predominant breed.
Here we go.
I know. Okay, promise no politics on this.
We're going to turn it into what's better, Guernseys or Jerseys. Yeah, you bet.
Okay, we're good.
So far, what's the reaction been from consumers?
It's been really positive, particularly highlighting, they appreciate being talked to and being shared with their concerns, and it's just been a positive influence over outlook.
It's the Undeniably Dairy program, brand new from Dairy Management Incorporated, to help reach out to consumers of dairy products. We're at World Dairy Expo. I'm Brian Winnikins for Real Country 1430 WRDN.
Thanks, Brian.